following is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
And welcome all to another excellent edition of the Power Trading Hour. It doesn't matter whether you're in Poughkeepsie or a little tipsy. We love it when you come to us at this time. If I can find my mouse, where it is right there. At this time.
The following takes place between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m.
So what do we have going on today? Well, a little bit of a pullback in the markets. And what do we got? 23, yeah, off 22 on the S&P cash. It's been very, very light. And that it meant the volume down. The bounces have been light on the volume. Overall, just a very light day so far. Just 6 billion shares, so even lighter than on Friday, which wasn't a big move to the upside. My belief, which I put in the newsletter this morning, The Path of Least Resistance, available over most of TFNN. Go to the front page of the website, and you can take a look at it. Anyway, figured a little back and forth Monday and Tuesday. My thoughts are that by Wednesday, they're going to start anticipating Fed cash again as they start generally coming in on Thursday, pushing some into Friday. And sometimes you get, you know, some in Monday morning, which we got a little bit. Market went, yeah, did okay. Then it rolled back over. So we got a couple of days where cash not coming in, people kind of selling into it. You know, it's options expiration. Am I expecting anything significantly lower? No. My guess is that we are going to start seeing lighter volume all the way probably to the 1st of June and then into summer trading. So probably a little lighter volume that we're kind of used to over the last few months. And, you know, do we get a break on light volume and the market just continues to sell off in June? Well, that's one possibility, one I kind of think is would be more than likely than us selling off before the end of the month. But, you know, anything can happen. People talking about war in the den right now. Everything's always, you know, anything can change. But right now, it just kind of looks like the market's ready to kind of, I'm going to say, stumble its way up into the three-day weekend. But especially this week, there's just not a lot of signs. Options, as I continue to look at them and they start coming back into focus, have changed the market for about 4, maybe 5 months. It's been incredibly hard to get them to predict anything, mostly because everybody's been on one side of the market. Something I haven't seen in 20 years, but doesn't mean that things can't get weird like that again. I just think that we're probably more in a two-way market than we were for the 4 months of euphoria or 5 months of the euphoria going in to these recent tops. Now, what do? Well, I think we start to pay a lot more attention to the medium-term charts and know that the market is a two-way street. As I said last week, one of the things, even in a bear market, people don't believe or don't think of is that the market's always going up about 3/4 of the time. In a bull market, you know, it just means that you're going up a lot more than the 1/4 of the time that it's going lower. In a bear market, you get monster rips of several days, in which case then you go up slightly for a whole bunch of days. And then you get the next big move lower. I'm kind of thinking that we're more like the second part of that, but we shall see. Like I said, so far today, not a lot going on in the volume that would make you want to scream, pull the ripcord, I need a parachute, get me out of here. In fact, if when you look deep inside the market, We've been selling off for 4 or 5 months. What hasn't happened is the indexes haven't really participated in it because, like the NASDAQ 100, six of them are, 64% of the entire NASDAQ? You can have, I'm going to say 95% of the market did sell off over the last 4 months or 5 months. It's that last couple of FANG stocks and others that really have held the market up, as a lot of these stocks got heavily discounted and really in retrospect don't look that bad. But just because a market goes lower doesn't mean you should buy it. Same as just because it goes higher, you should. Okay. I think that's pretty much it for that. Anything else going on here? I got a few questions already. We'll get into that in the next segment. We'll do a little history, and then we'll be all queued up to go after that, answer some questions, look at some stocks with really high short interest, which is when I get into the lighter volume, the old saying is don't be short a quiet market. That's because when you get really nailed by short sellers. But we'll see how that works out. But we'll look at some short stocks today. We tried to get into it on Thursday and Friday and just never quite got there. Things were moving, but we'll do a little history here.
And it's all just a little bit of history repeating.
On this day in 1943, the crew of the Memphis Belle, one of the group of American bombers based in Britain, becomes the first B-17 crew to complete 25 missions over Europe. Of course, most people weren't making 15 missions up to that point before they were either shot down or killed in action. There was only one thing that was worse than being a B-17 crew for your life expectancy, and that was being a submarine crew, a German submarine crew, after about the summer of 1942, which by the end of the war, things got a little bit better for the B-17 crews. But up to that point, 80% chance you were going to spend the rest of the war either in a prisoner of war camp or as a MIA. But about the same thing. By the end of the war, I think, 80% of everybody that went to war in a submarine, German submarine, never came home. And that meant even the ones, that's counting even the POWs, which I think there were about two submarines that ended up giving up and going to, Arizona. Because I remember one of the commanders tried to leg it out. Didn't get too far. I don't think they have a lot of deserts in Germany, but you don't know. Anyway, on this day in 1943, the Memphis Belle performed its 25th and last mission. It's been fully restored, and you can go to it. Where is it at now? I saw the whole documentary on them redoing it. They spent 15 years restoring the Memphis Belle. What is that? Be back in a minute.
If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. If you're not currently using the TAS profile scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
And first question on the top of the stack, thoughts on Riot. And I don't spend that much time on Bitcoin, so I can't tell you about that. I would just look at the chart here. Again, almost everything that I'm based on is on the past predicts the future, at least at some level. And, of course, without much past, I don't have a lot of edge in picking it, why I kind of stay away from Bitcoin. Of course, Riot. Kind of in that vein, but you know, you came back down. Energy really is not that bad on this last leg to about 21. It pretty much needs to hold this level, but you're back to a gap higher. That gap happened on February 8th of this year. That popped up. What are we going to call it? 52 million shares. Came back into it with 36 million shares. Kind of going out here. I would suggest that this thing's probably found some level of support. I think that's kind of like the whole market. Everything's pulled back except a handful of big stocks, and they did it last week. So now what are we, and the index has started to move. So the question is whether or not this holds support. I'm not a fan of this whole sector, but if you were and looked at this chart and erased the top there, so I knew, I kind of knew what this sector wasn't in, that I didn't know anything about it, chart wouldn't look that bad. But in fact, that's a, you know, sometimes a good way to actually do that. Sometimes just putting a post-it note over the name of the stock and just going through them as fast as you can without paying much attention, and then going back, taking the post-it note off where the symbol is and the name of the stock is sometimes a good way of taking out some bias in it. I'm just not a big fan of it, but hey, what the hey. Okay. Other questions. Are we sure that the ransomware from last week originated from Russia? And probably the most interesting thing is they found a way to get around almost all these crime kits that were authored by the bunch that brought us the great pipeline shutdown of 2021. Guess what? If you have a Russian keyboard or a couple like that, some in that area, or the Russian language pack in Windows, it will not work. That's literally all you have to put in to make sure that it quits. So apparently, whoever wrote this didn't want it coming back to them in their homeland. So you got to figure that, it's probably Russia or some of the areas that are heavily Russian in what is that? Not Yugoslavia. Where's all the wheat there? Right on there. Yeah, I'll think of it in a minute. Anyway, pretty good indications that is where it came from, just because they didn't want it coming back at them. No, not Macedonia. What's the one where all the giant wheat is there just on the west side of Russia that they're always fighting back and forth? It's not Yugoslavia. It's the big one. Giant wheat as far as the land can I can see. Oh, Ukraine. Thank you. Yeah, I couldn't just think of that right off the bat. Senior moment. So that's it. Anyway, I don't have a lot going on here. We're going to look at a few other stocks that have super high short interest in it. We talked a little bit about this last week. Zillow, I was interested in playing that because it looked very good for options on Friday, pulling back today. Again, I'll probably look at about on Wednesday on looking at options play for options expiration, generally because you get, 3, 4, 6 weeks of decay in options for the monthlies. And they tend to hold on to those. There is opportunity, at least a little better opportunity than the weeklies, although the weeklies have been getting better in pricing, mostly, I think, because everybody being on one side for the last 4 months. But I still really like playing the monthly options expiration because you got a lot more time watching how they move and shake and how everybody lines up on each side. But Zillow, anyway, it looked like it was going to go to 1250. Did a really, excuse me, 112.50. Did a little bit more than that on Friday. The high was 113.32. But that was one of the two that looked like it was just going to pop on some short sellers. But pretty heavy on this. And again, if you go sideways here for a while, you always want to catch the rips. One of the other one that really interests me is Iron Mountain. The reason Iron Mountain, I think, is so interesting is that if I got one of these ransomware things, I just go back to a backup I had when it wasn't there. And since I do one for every night, it does it automatically at 2 a.m. If the file size dramatically changed, then I'd know that someone was doing something on my hard drive that I was unaware of. I pretty much know the size of the backups, and I look at them each day just to make sure they're there and get verified. But, I can always go back and do that, and I take during the day, generally in the morning, I've got some thumb drives. I'll just back up one to the thumb drive, and it's always outside the computer. So if I ever got anything, I haven't. But if I ever did, I'd always go back to that backup on my on the thumb drive. But Iron Mountain is a giant place where backups are stored. They go into old mine shafts, a lot of them fairly large for iron and copper. A lot of these things are, 100 years old, the mines are. But they'll go in there, and since there's so much metal already in the stone, they can go up there and put some kind of light screen, throw some concrete on the walls, which they kind of spray this very light concrete. It kind of gets whipped up like soft serve ice cream. And so now it's all shielded from electro pulse of the sun or the North Koreans or whoever wants to give us a nice pulse that would wipe everything out. And I think I said something a couple weeks ago or maybe last week about being in one of these that's now nothing but storage for old tapes and hard drives so people can go back to it. I think a lot of these folks, they just think things are moving so quickly, backups don't do them any good. But it kind of reminds me of riding motorcycles. There's the old story of two kind of motorcycle riders, ones that have been down, ones that are going down. You better plan on crashing at some point. That means wear a helmet, nice jacket, good boots. We'll be back in a minute.
Hi, folks. This is Tom O'Brien. The printing presses are working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The U.S. deficit has risen 200% in 1 year with no end in sight. The markets are looking for an additional stimulus bill to get us through this once-in-a-generation pandemic. There is no free lunch, folks. The more stimulus dollars put into the marketplace, the less your dollar is worth each and every day. This is the time to protect yourself with a portion of your portfolio in the metal market. The Gold Report comes out each Monday morning. I bisect and dissect the dollar, silver, gold, the XAU, and the HUI. The Gold Report is a long-term hedge against the dilution of your buying power. The U.S. has put more than $6 trillion into the marketplace in the last 6 months, with more expected in the next few months. The market did and does need the stimulus, but it will have long-term implications on our buying power. The Gold Report comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Go to TFNN.com and order the Gold Report now. Protect your buying power. Order the Gold Report now.
You could be making money off the stock market. And if you're already making money off the stock market, you could be making a lot more. Check out TFNN and Tiger TV and get expert investing advice to give you the power to control your financial future. Go to TFNN.com and find the newsletter for you. Whether you're into trading gold, metals, futures, currencies, or options, you'll get advice and analysis to help you seriously get ahead. TFNN also features trading services with a 30-day money-back guarantee for new subscribers, as well as TFNN's Tiger Den trading room, trading software, and educational webinars for all trading levels. And make sure you check out Tiger TV for free on TFNN.com or TFNN's YouTube channel for live financial content from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern on market days. Stop watching on the sidelines while other people get rich and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the market for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hey, I've got a couple of questions. First one here is, do you see a continuous bid in the SPYs through Friday? And I don't know if I would say continuous. I would say there's a good chance of 4150 to 4200 in the S&P cash. That's kind of wide. Generally, you get it a little bit better. And maybe by Wednesday, I'll get a little bit better. But this is a fairly thin market, as you can see by the action today. You get some fairly sharp moves on very light volume. So I don't think there's a whole lot in here other than the market going sideways, just maybe stumbling up into Friday. So, yeah, 41.50. I wouldn't call it a continuous bid. Could we pull back 25 and then go up, you know, 45? Yes. But my guess is we're just going to have a little back and forth today, tomorrow. Wednesday, we're going to start anticipating the Fed coming in with cash. They're going to front run it a little bit on Thursday. And then, of course, into Friday. Generally, we have a lot of cash coming in from the Fed by then. And we can look. Now, you know, one of the things that would really make me think different of this would be a big difference or a big change in the TLT. It's down 32 cents. My guess is that the Fed is trying to draw a line where it will support stuff, and it can for a while above 36.50. But I think, you know, probably by the end of the month, it's going to get harder and harder. People are just going to continue to sell in there. I saw more people talking about bond vigilantes this week. Of course, we started talking about that back in the middle of January. It's just going to be tough. I don't think a lot of people want to be in bonds at all. But the short-term view is something like 4150 to 4200 on the S&P cash for Friday. And, you know, this is kind of like starting off with two aces in a Texas Hold'em game. And you see a third ace pop up on the flop. Your hand's pretty good. Can you still get beat? Yes. You get two kings, and, you know, you think, well, maybe somebody gets a full house in some weird way that chases it down. Yeah, you can still get beat, and things change. So you just want to keep that. But right now, you can only play with what you know. And I think a fairly decent indication that we go sideways to slightly higher into Friday. Okay, other things going on here. We talked about that. Oh, question about what I do with my thumb drives, which I have mine here, right here. This is a 128 gigabyte thumb drive, or 256. 256 gigabyte hard drive, thumb drive. I've got one of those little Altoid cans, which is really all you need. As long as the top and the bottom touch each other, so you can get a little file and make sure that they're touching each other and make a good seal. But that's really all you need. You really, to get hit by MP and wipe things out, you need something about 3 feet long, like a power cord, which is why computers are so susceptible. It's like having the perfect antenna on a lot of these things, since the power cords are just about that long. I think if the power cord's like 1 foot, it only gets about 10, it gets 10 times less than a power cord 3 feet. And I think that's even less than a 6 foot power cord. So generally, long runs of copper providing electricity. Laptops, of course, if you're not plugged in, will do fairly well in an EMP blast. But, you know, we're talking about something like maybe a solar flare or something. You're going to get a lot of kind of forward advance on that being a problem. You know, we know it's kind of like a hurricane. You kind of know that it's coming. So I'm not so much worried about that as something like a lightning strike. That would come close. And of course, there's a reason why the hockey team here in Tampa is called the Lightning. It is the lightning capital of the world. There's only one place that gets more lightning. And this, it's a island off the coast of, I don't know, Africa or South America, that's literally like 80% made out of metal. But other than that, we get more lightning than anybody else. Anyway, other high shorted stocks, Bed Bath and Beyond had a nice little rip on Monday with some decent volume. Today, a little higher, nothing in the volume really saying anything, and nothing really in that, just light volume. But my question is, you know that the Reddit guys and the Robinhoods are still out there. And the question is, you know, now that people are starting to pile back into shorts, which one of these guys are they going to take out the first? And there's a handful of them. This is one that they did fairly well on, but people are piling back in and in big numbers on. So you want to keep it on that. That's why I brought up Iron Mountain. Kind of neat. Had a question also about somewhere. Where is it at here? No, it was in here. About taking a look at FireEye. F-E-Y-E. I can't remember who did it. Maybe it was in the den. FireEye making lower highs and higher lows. You're really now to the point where you're getting to the point of this breaking out one way or the other. I would love and normally love to play big triangle patterns like this in going the opposite way. Since it's not above $30, I'm probably not going to short it. So my best thing would be that for this to break down, have a lot of selling for like one day and then come back into the trading range. But you've got a pretty nice triangle here that goes back to the high of 25.53. That was December 23rd of last year to December 10th of last year. And you're in this area now. You're just consolidating. I'd love for it to wash everybody out one day, come back up, and that's probably where I think the big move on this is going to be. Great part of the market to be in. The problem is no one wants to pay any money for security. And until the CEOs, kind of like they got their hands caught in the cookie jar last week for the pipeline, they're really going to have to pay a price before they start spending the money. You got kind of the same kind of pattern in HAC, which is the cybersecurity ETF. I would have loved to see that. You did have a higher high on much lighter volume in HAC. It's not a huge volume player now, but I suspect when it gets out of this, that'll be the next big rip like we had. What is that? From about we got here? From October, end of October last year to the high on January 27th of this year. I think this thing's just going sideways. We're going to get the next rip like that. Nice 50% movement act. Be back.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
The technology around us is changing every day. With so much happening, it can seem impossible to keep up with all the information. David White's investment newsletter, The Technology Insider, is designed to give you all the information you need to understand the technology that shapes today's markets and tomorrow's future. David White has made his living staying on the cutting edge of technology. His weekly newsletter will give you specific recommendations for value tech stocks, as well as entry prices, target prices, and stops to set for each trade. Dave delivers his weekly newsletters every Friday with updates throughout the week. You can get the Technology Insider at TFNN.com for only $37.50. Sign up for David's newsletter, The Technology Insider, and get an inside look at everything the technology sector has to offer. Try it risk-free today with our 30-day money-back guarantee. TFNN, educating investors.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
And as we go to this thing, you can still have plenty of time to call me at 877-927-6648. If you have a deep and burning question, this is a good day to give a call as lines are open at that phone number. Give me a call or email me at path at tfnn.com or put a message in the den if you want to talk about anything. Talking to one of the den members in here about why CEOs just won't spend the money. And I think that I'd say 95% of them have no idea about what cybersecurity is. They don't understand how to pay for it, the costs or why they should pay for it. They just look at, you know, I can save this $2 million in software this quarter if I just act like nothing's happened. And eventually, you know, there'll be enough and people will, you know, they'll get sued, the insurance companies will quit covering them, and it will move on. So that would be a little bit of it. Other massively shorted stocks, Cree, of course, it makes LED, high LED bulbs. $90, fairly decent support area on this. What do you got? Fairly light volume on the downside, but you got a nice left-hand shoulder right about this area that started, what are we going to say? I'm going to say this started on last week of November and ran till about mid-December before it started going in this trading range between, let's call it 130 and 95-ish. We're a little bit below that on the market pulling back, but volume not all that exciting so far. Again, I think I'm not exactly sure which one of these are out there, but we got a lot of the same kind of conditions. Now, there's a few stocks that I wouldn't want to be long in no matter what. New York Times Company is one. These guys have, I don't know, a ton. I'm going to just call it a metric ton of lawsuits for disparaging individuals. And most of those, I think they're going to lose. I don't think this is actually worth that much. They've become much more of an opinion piece than anything resolving or revolving facts. But they've got some huge lawsuits pending on stuff that's pretty easy to prove that they besmirched the reputations of some folks. And these folks were smart enough before they ever got started to make sure that everything that they did had a lawyer check it, unlike the New York Times, which just put out a bunch of pablum that is not going to hold up. This is, I think, there's one judge now that's literally sitting on all of these lawsuits for the New York Times. And he's more than been vocal about New York Times saying that they can't be sued for libel, saying that these guys have pretty much given up all journalistic ethics altogether. So I wouldn't see it. To Polar, didn't Creed divest its lighting unit? Not that I know of, but it'd be something I'd have to take a look at. I still see their sign on all the high-powered lights and flashlights and stuff, but I don't think they divested it. But okay. Question from Ron about the SMHs. You got support, kind of hit right at it the other day. You bounced a little. I'd love to see this come back to about 220, 218-ish on light volume, and then that would be it. The energy down was a little stronger than you would like to see. It's about the same on the way up and down to that April 5th high in that, but that's kind of it. Don't see it. Your screen not showing stock, hogs, and thoughts. Screen not showing your stocks, hogs. Huh. Everybody sees my screen okay? I don't know what this first part of this message says. Hopefully everybody can see my charts in the den. Let me know. Yeah. Cree building a new planet. Plant. Thoughts on Roku and Goldman Sachs. Let's do Goldman Sachs. I think we talked about Roku on Friday already. My screen not showing stocks. Okay. We see. Okay. Looks good. The Goldman Sachs. Actually, what do we have here? Let's go back to displaced moving average. You got a pretty nice setup for a double repo pattern to the downside in Goldman Sachs, but you don't have any confirmation of it at all. What you want is this to get kind of closer back to the 3x3 or even a 5x7 displaced moving average, or 7x5, excuse me. And you really don't have that much. So it'd take a lot to get that turned around. As I said, I'm not a big fan this week of going after short positions. I suspect everybody's going to get short. The volume's going to decay all the way after Friday. And, you know, it just happens so many years in a row that you just have that low volume push of a handful of stocks higher or just sideways. But my guess is we'll have kind of a week, May 24th, through the end of the month, which I'll be on vacation at already, because I like that time of the year, because a lot of stuff generally doesn't happen. We see SMH now. We have something. Okay. That's good. The Goldman Sachs, got that. Okay. Roku. Hogs and shows hogs. Your screen not showing the stocks show hogs. I don't know if you want to looking at hogs. Okay. Harley Davidson, maybe that's what he wanted to look at. Volume today, not that bad going into 2.3 million shares of April 23rd, $50.67. You got decent volume today, and you may even hold the high. Maybe everybody did decide to buy a Harley Davidson. Of course, that's not how they make money. They make it selling all the accoutrement that people hang on it, mufflers, chrome, leather saddlebags, all the other kind of stuff that goes on these things. Maybe that's been real good this spring. Maybe stimulus checks went to Harley Davidson. I didn't read the news on it today. I would have liked to seen a little bit more volume. But all you really need is more volume than the last high. And you got a million more shares, and you're going to close a buck above it. Nice candle, good, decent volume. Could get more. But, you know, you got another hour. So Harley Davidson, not a bad little stop.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Markets can rise and fall like the tides. Subscribe to Basil Chapman's newsletter, The Opening Call, and you too can ride the wave. Basil Chapman is an authority in technical analysis. His Chapman Wave trading system has been helping traders identify trends and capitalize on momentum in the markets since 1984. TFNN invites you to test Basil's proprietary Chapman Wave trading methodology with a monthly subscription to the Opening Call newsletter for only $149. Your subscription to the Opening Call comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee, as well as daily market updates on key indexes, stocks, and commodities. Ride the wave. Sign up for the Opening Call risk-free today.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today, our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge. Just $89, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
And the last question out here is from Jane, who wants to talk about Micron. What's going on this, and how can such a great company come off the top? I think this thing's in just a bigger trading range, from about $75 to 100 here for a while. But remember, if there's a part missing, nothing gets built. You're not going to go and start building stuff, and then at the scale that most companies do now. When I was in manufacturing in the 90s and semiconductors, it was not uncommon to put everything on the board, but, you know, have one person resolder it just because of the time it would take to get the things turned around. But I'm talking about maybe doing a couple hundred boards. We're talking about doing a couple hundred boards an hour for a lot of these companies like NVIDIA. So they can't go back and do any work. If there's parts missing, they just can't get it done. So the problem is it's the weakest link. So if something's missing, they're just not getting it done. And in fact, I wrote about it in the Tech Insider for this week. And that is, if you missed it, go look at cheap television prices from last year. Some of them are up 50% because they can't get any parts. They had to pay up to get at least some of them. Even the mid-priced TVs, I'm talking about $300, $400, $500, up 30%. So it's not just a week in one sector of the car industry. It's all over. And it's just like getting caught in a bad traffic jam downtown coming home from work. You're going to inchworm your way out to the suburbs, and it's slowly going to get to some spot. And then guess what? You're back up to 65 cruising on the way home. We'll get that way. It's just hard to know. And it's no different than sitting in traffic. You don't know exactly when that's going to all start working its way out, but it will. I guess it's about midsummer. So when you can, not when you have to. We will see you here tomorrow. Same bat channel, same bat time.